गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर क्लास ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर फर्स्ट सेम सीएसई स्टूडेंट्स. सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट हाउ टू कन्वर्ट द इनफिक्स टू पोस्टफिक्स बाय ट्रेसिंग द प्रोग्राम. ओके, सो टुडे वी विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द सी प्रोग्राम और कोड कैन बी रिटन फॉर कन्वर्शन फ्रॉम इनफिक्स टू पोस्टफिक्स. सो लेट मी गो टू माई Turbo C++ software. So here, to avoid the timing taken for typing the program, so I have pre-typed it and have kept it ready. Okay. So first I am going to take all the header files what is required for my program to be executed. I hope you know about the header files. Header files are the library files that will help me to run my code. Okay, right. So here, as I said, I have taken two functions, f and g. So f is meant for the item at the top of the stack. G is meant for the element or the item that is going to be getting inputted, okay, in the general to say or in specific to say. F function indicates the stack precedence value, the stack precedence value of the element which is at the top of the stack, and then G function indicates the input precedence value for the element that is going to get inputted from the expression. Okay, so I hope you remember the table. So based on that table only I have made the entries here. So plus and minus, it is having value 2, then star and that is asterisk, that is multiplication and division is having the return value 4. Then raised to symbol and dollar sign is having the value 5. The opening of the parenthesis will be returned the value 0, and hash is having the minus 1 as the result. So other than these symbols, if there is an occurrence of operands, then it will take value as 8. In the same way, the function for the input precedence value is been written. So plus and minus, if it any of these appears, then it will return 1. Then multiplication and division will return 3. Raised to sign and dollar will return 6. Closing of the parenthesis will return 9. Opening of the parenthesis will return 9. Closing of the parenthesis will return 0. And defaultly, other than these symbols, if there is an occurrence of operand, then it will return 7. Okay, so the entries are made same according to what we saw the table in the previous class. Okay, next is I am writing the infix to postfix function. So I hope you remember, in the infix to postfix, what we are checking out: the element, if the element at the top of the stack is greater than the element that is going to be inputted from the expression, then I need to pop out the element from the top of the stack and put it in the postfix expression. Or if the condition fails, that is, if top of the stack, the element at the top of the stack is not equal to the element that is going to be inputted, then I can either pop it out from the stack and delete it. Okay, that thing I can do. But see that element which is popped will not be entered in the postfix expression. So for your convenience sake, I have kept here comments, single line comments, as I have used single line comments as well as multi line comments. I hope you remember these comments will help us to understand what my program will do. Okay, so first I have taken the top as an initialization. So here this indicates the top of the stack every time whenever it is marked at. Okay, then j, it is an index variable for postfix expression. J is used for keeping track the index values of postfix expression. I is index value or a variable used to access the infix expression. Okay, then next, I have taken one array s, so this is of the type character and it can store 30 memory spaces. Then next another one, variable I have taken symbol, it is also of a type character. Okay, so here this symbol will hold the scanned character from the infix expression. As and all I start comparing, first I need to take it inside one of the character, so that character is a symbol. So initially my stack, top of the stack is marking empty, that is what I am kept it as -1. So since -1 value we will assign to the hash, so I have initialized the stack to hash. Then j, I hope you remember, this is the index variable for keeping track of the postfix expression. So earlier it will be empty, so I am initializing it to the 0. Next, let me go for the for loop. So here in the for loop, what I have taken? I have taken the index value that is used to access the infix expression. Okay, then up till what it will be accessed? Up till the string length, strlen. strlen function will help me to check out the total string length of the infix expression. So until and unless this string length is completed, it will be keep on repeating. Okay, then I++ will go for the next iteration. Okay, so what is there in the for loop? So first I will start checking the each and every term of the symbol that is getting from the infix expression. So since we are starting from the 0th index, so first it will be I am assigning the infix of the 0th index to the symbol. So it means what? Now symbol has got at least one component available to compare with the top of the stack. So immediately what I will do, I will just take that symbol and compare with the top of the stack. I hope you remember F represents the precedence value for the top of the stack and G represents the input precedence value for the input symbol. So preferably I am taking in a correct mapping order. Okay, so anyway, S is the stack element where I can store the data. Okay, then here I will check the condition. I know you remember the condition. If the top of the stack is greater than the symbol, then what I will do, I will pop that particular element. This is what I am doing, top minus minus. I am going to pop that particular element from the top and put it in the postfix expression. So here postfix expression is represented by j. It is represented by j index value. So if there is an element which is having the top element greater at the stack, then that will be compared with the symbol. If it is greater, then that will be popped first and then assigned to the postfix expression. So as we and all keep on assigning a value to the postfix expression, it will be incremented every time. And this while loop will execute only if the top of the stack is greater than the symbol. Okay, suppose this condition does not hold good, so what it will do, it will go for the if condition. In this if condition, we are comparing that either if top of the stack is not equal to the symbol, what is made available in the next input stream or else next input expression. So if it is the case, so what I can do, then I can add up this symbol, that is I can push inside the top of the stack, by first pre-incrementing the top of the stack and then making the space available for the top to store the data, then that is symbol. I am going to insert in that. Else, if it is the case where push operation is not relevant, then else I will go to remove the top of the element of the stack and then just keep it as it is. I am not going to put inside the postfix expression. So I hope this function is been understood by you. Same thing what I was doing in the theoretical explanation regarding the trace of the program, same thing I am applying. I am doing nothing change here. Okay, next. So once the content is been traced, if there else remains any symbols or any expression, reliable expression is remaining, then what I can do, I can just keep on simply pushing that into the top of the stack, or else popping that and put it in the postfix expression. So this while loop will check until the condition that whether top is empty, that is hash, that is -1. So until and unless the top is -1, until and unless it is not -1, then keep on getting the elements of the top of the stack and put it in the postfix expression. That is what this while loop is doing. Okay, then once it is done, finally what I will do, I will keep the null value for the postfix expression. So always remember, once we are using the string, we should keep the null value at the end of the string, or else it will be taken in the infinite way. So your program will not work properly. So that's why what I am doing at the end, I am keeping null value. Okay, then next, let's go to the main function. So why do we write the main function? To execute our program. So main is the function that will help me to execute the program. Okay, so here what I have taken, two character arrays, that is infix as well as postfix. So infix will be what I am going to give as an input, postfix will be what the expression I will get after conversion from infix to postfix. That postfix expression will be stored in this array. Okay, then next, I am applying clear screen command so that previous output whatever I got should not hinder my present output. So for this special case, CLR, SCR and another function called as a getch, to make them work properly, that is what I am using, the conio.h as an the header file that is been included here. I hope you remember this string.h is used to process the stringed elements. So since we have taken many of the string elements here and we are going to get input of the string like infix expression, then of course I need to process it up. So that's why I am including the header file string.h. Okay, then let me go back to the main function. So here, first I will ask the user to enter the valid infix expression through the printf statement. So since I am going to get it from the keyboard, so I will use the scanf statement. So I hope you might be thinking that why I have not used ampersand and here. So I hope I would like to revise you how to use the scanf statement with the string. In the string, when I am getting the data from the keyboard as a string, then there is no need of using the ampersand and. Directly I am going to keep the things where I want to store it. So here I am going to get the infix expression. This infix expression I want to keep in the array infix. That's why I am referring here as infix. Okay, now start converting from infix to postfix. So that's why the reason I will call the function infix postfix. So whatever infix expression I am getting it from the keyboard, that I will put it as a parameter, and another postfix I am putting as another parameter wherein I can store the data after conversion from infix to postfix. Okay, next, the postfix Next, I want to get the relevant output after getting the expression converted from infix to postfix. So I am printing it in a better way. So I am printing the data first, the postfix expression is. So here the postfix expression will be stored in the postfix array. The postfix array. So I am printing it in a particular relevant way. Okay. So this here finally the getch function is available. The function of the getch is that it will keep on displaying the content of the content at the output console after the press of the run button, or else after giving the proper input to the particular C program. Okay, so once the input is been given, you will press enter to process it. So once it is processed, I hope you remember in the traditional way, we don't get the output directly. Again, we need to go for a window, then to open the output console. Other than that, if you use this getch function, immediately after running the program, you will be able to get the output displayed on the console, output console. So not to make more delay, let me run this code. Okay, it is asking me for enter a valid infix expression. So you can take the examples of the previous expressions, or else let me give the input here. Okay, so I will take one expression with the parenthesis and another one I will take without parenthesis. So here I will take it as something like, then plus B, close of the bracket, then star C minus, again opening of the bracket, then D minus E, then close of two brackets, then rest symbol, opening of the bracket, then F plus G, close of the bracket, press enter. You are going to get the postfix expression. To verify the output, you can go for any of the two different ways, that is either through conventional way, or again you can trace the program on your own by keeping the table. Okay, right. I hope you understood about the output. Thank you. So let me go back to my presentation mode. So this is what the C program that we learned just now to convert an infix expression to postfix expression. Okay. Fine. So next is to learn about how to convert from infix expression to the prefix expression. I hope you remember about the definition of prefix. So symbol, the operator will be present before the appearance of two operands. Okay. So infix expression means operator will be in between the operands. In the prefix expression, operator will be prior or precedings, or will be available earlier to the operands, earlier to the appearance of the operands. So here let us go first for the conventional way for converting from infix expression to the prefix expression for the expression given, infix expression given on the screen. Okay, so what I will do, I will open the Word document to do this activity. Let me copy this so that I no need to retype the content. Though then let me go for the Word. Okay, it is opened. So let me copy this table for my convenience, as that later I can use this directly. ओके लेट मी गो फॉर द न्यू पेज. सो इट इज इन फिक्स एक्सप्रेशन टू. Prefix expression. So for your convenience, let me make it as large. So I will put out the expression here. Okay, let me recopy it from the presentation. Okay. I hope the question is same. The question is same. I am just going to convert it into the prefix. So what I will do immediately, I will remove the content of the table so that I can convert it to the postfix expression. Sorry, prefix expression. Okay. So I remove the content from the table. Then let us start evaluating this. So as I told, I will take the innermost innermost part of the expression, which the innermost parenthesis is occurring. So here this is b minus c. So I will paste it here. So b minus c, if I go for the prefix, then what will be the equivalent result? So it will be minus b c. So let me give this as t1. Okay, now I'm going to replace the content of b minus c to t1. So b minus c, I'm going to place it as t1. Okay, now next. Now the innermost loop is innermost expression having the parenthesis is this one. So here I have two operators, plus and star. So among these two, the highest precedence is for the star. Its value is what? 4. Okay, then plus is having the value 2. So I need to give the preference to t1 star d. So t1 star d I am going to evaluate next. So its equivalent prefix expression is star t1 and then d. So let me give then equivalent to t2. I will mark it as t2. Then what is the remaining expression available? So this t1 and star d is being named now as t2. Okay, so the innermost expression is a plus t2. So I will take this for conversion next. A plus t2, how can I put it in a prefix form? It will be plus then a and t2. Okay, so this a plus t2 is converted to plus a t2. So what will be the remaining expression of mine? So it will be opening and closing the bracket, then it will be, okay, let me take its equivalent as t3 plus a t2. Let me take it equivalent as t3. Now put it in here in this. So it will be what? T3 then raised to e then plus f. So in this expression I have two operators, raised to symbol and the plus operator. So as accordingly the precedence for the raised to symbol is 6 and plus is 2. So that's why first I will go for evaluation of t3 raised to 3. So that is t3 raised to e. So its equivalent postfix expression is, it is raised to then t3 then e. okay, let me give this name as T4. So my resulting expression is T4 plus F. T4 plus F. Okay. D4 plus F. So let me convert it into the postfix. So T4 plus F, its equivalent prefix expression is, sorry, it is plus T4 F. Let me give the value as T5. So I will start expanding the values. I will start expanding the values. So first it is T5. So T5 means what? It is T5 means it is plus T4F. Okay. So let me rewrite it as plus T4F. What is the value of T4? T4 value is it is raised to symbol, then T3, then E. So here at the place T4, put the same thing, that is plus T4, it is raised to symbol, then T3, then E. Finally remaining is F. Okay, now what is the value of T3? So the value of T3 is plus A T2. Plus A T2. So replace the same thing here. Replace the same thing here. So plus raised to, in the place of T3 I need to put plus A T2. And remaining is E F. So next, what do you mean by T2? T2 means it is star T1D. So at the place of T2, put the star T1D. So it will be like plus raised to, again plus, then A. At the place of T2, I need to put star T1D. Then remaining is E and F. So now T1 means what? T1 means it is minus B C. So replace the value of T1 as minus B C here. So the resulting prefix expression is plus raised to, again plus, then A, then star. So T1 value is minus B C. Then it is D, then E and F. Okay, so this is the resulting prefix expression for the equivalent infix expression. So let me keep it here, let me assign it here. Okay, right. Then next I will take another expression. I will take another expression, that is x raised to y, then again raised to z minus m plus n plus p divided by q. I hope here there is no appearance of parenthesis, and let me start converting it to from infix to prefix. Let me reuse this table so that I can apply the conversion process easily. So I will put it here and I will remove the contents of the table. Let me better go for the new page. So here I'm going to remove the content of the elements of the table. Okay, so the new expression, let me paste it inside. So it is x raised to y raised to z minus m plus n plus p divided by q. So here z I have kept small, let me take it as a capital. Okay, right. Let me do the same here. Okay. So let us start converting. So here I don't have parenthesis. I think is what I need to consider the precedence and associativity of the operator. So when I compare among these operators, I have associativity and precedence providing more priority to the raised to symbol. But since I have two raised to symbol and its associativity is from right to left, its associativity is from right to left. So the expression what I do convert first is y raised to z. The expression what I do convert first is y raised to z. So y raised to z, what is the equivalent prefix expression for this? It will be raised to y and z, like this, raised to y, z. Let me give this equivalent as t1. Okay. Now, y raised to z I am replacing as t1. Okay. So instead of simply typing it, let me copy paste it and change y raised to z as t1. Next, again I have the highest precedence value as raised to symbol. So next I will go for x raised to t1 to convert into from infix to prefix. So x raised to t1, its equivalent prefix expression is, its equivalent prefix expression is raised to symbol, then x, then t1. So let me take it equivalent as t2. So everything is well and done. Let me copy this and paste it. So x raised to t1, I will place it as sorry guys, one second. X raised to t1, I will take it as t2. Now, there is plus symbol, minus symbol and division. So when compared to the precedence and associativity, okay, so plus and minus is having same precedence, that is 2. And division is having the highest priority, that is 4. So first let me go for p divided by q. So next expression that I am going to convert is infix to prefix is p divided by q. So its equivalent prefix is, prefix expression is divided by p q. So let me take equivalent to, let me take this as equivalent to t3. So my remaining expression is t2 minus m plus n, again plus, it is t3. So among these, minus and plus are having the same precedence, that is true, but what is the associativity? Is left to right. So first I will go for evaluation or conversion from infix to postfix, that is t2 minus m. T2 minus m I will convert first. So its equivalent prefix expression is minus t2 m. So let me keep it equivalent as t4. So it will be lot t4 plus, remaining terms are n plus t3. So now I have two plus symbols. Since it is left associative, I will go for expression evaluation, that is t4 plus n. So I will keep it here t4 plus m, n. So its equivalent prefix is plus t4 n. So let me take equivalent it as t5. So remaining is what? T5 plus T3. So I need to convert it into for infix to prefix. So let me convert it. So its equivalent prefix expression is plus T5 T3. Let me take equivalent it as T6. Okay, so now I need to start expanding this T6. So T6, as you know, it is plus T5 63. So what is T5? T5 is nothing but plus, it is here, you see, plus T4n. So place that same thing here instead of at the place of T5. It is plus plus again plus T4n. Then what is the value of T3? T3 value is divided by PQ. Okay, then next. What is T4? T4 is having the value minus T2m. So resulting prefix expression will be, instead of T4 I will write minus T2m, and remaining is n, then divided by PQ. So what do you mean by T2? T2 means raised to x T1. So that is plus minus raised to x T1, then remaining is what? Mn, then divided by operator PQ. So what is T1? Okay, what is T1? Let me get a table here. So it is, T1 is nothing but raised to YZ. So it is like plus, again plus, then minus, then raised to, then X. At the place of T1 I need to put raised to Y, then Z, then remaining MN divided by P, then Q. So this is the resulting prefix expression for the postfix expression here given. Okay. So next is we need to study about how can I do design the function for the conversion from infix to prefix in programmatical way. So that we will discuss tomorrow. So we understood about these two expression, converting from infix to prefix and the conventional way. So tomorrow we will learn about the functions and their precedence values, what it has been taken for the conversion for the expression from infix to prefix, and then later on we will see the design of the code also with some more suitable examples. Okay, right. So thanks for attending the class. So meet you guys tomorrow. Thank you. Take care.